Artificial intelligence translates brainwaves into photos. Researchers are developing a sort of mind-reading technology using artificial intelligence to see what people are thinking via their brain signals. Researchers at Radboud University published their results in Nature about experiments where they showed photos of faces to volunteers while using a functional magnetic resonance imaging scanner, also known as an fMRI. This is a kind of non-invasive technology for imaging that measures blood flow changes in the brain. The fMRI scanned the activity of neurons in the occipital lobe of the volunteers, which is an area responsible for vision, while they were looking at images of faces, and then the data was fed into an artificial intelligence algorithm which reconstructed the exact image of the faces being observed. Furthermore, the researchers believe that they can train the artificial intelligence algorithm to not only accurately picture any facial expression being observed, but also any facial expression which can be vividly imagined, such as the face of a volunteer's mother. The experiment results showed that fMRI coupled with artificial intelligence was able to achieve exceptional accuracy in the image reconstruction process, which produced outputs almost identical to the images that were originally shown. The study was led by artificial intelligence researchers with backgrounds in cognitive neuroscience and showed impressive results of the potential for AI systems to read minds in the future. By developing this technology, it could lead to the ability to decode and create subjective experiences, possibly even your dreams. This technological knowledge could be used in clinical applications, such as communication with patients who are locked in deep comas. The work also focused on the combination of fMRI and AI technology to restore vision in those who have lost their sight due to diseases or accidents. To this end, they are currently developing brain implant cameras to stimulate people's brains to give them back their vision. In order to train the artificial intelligence algorithm, the volunteers were shown a series of faces while the fMRI was scanning their brain signals. The key to the experiment was that they did not see photographs of real people, but instead were computer-generated faces, which were the result of the back propagation from a convolutional neural network, also known as computer vision. The fMRI scan was able to detect the neural responses of volunteers in real time as they observed these computer vision-generated images. The artificial intelligence system then converted these neural responses back into pixel values, allowing them to create an output of the faces. Quantum AI breakthrough reduces the need for training data. Contrary to previous assumptions that were based on classical computing's enormous appetite for data in machine learning or artificial intelligence, training a quantum neural system requires very little data. The theorem can be applied to many areas, including faster compilation for quantum computers and the distinction of phases of matter in materials discovery. It has now been shown repeatedly by quantum theorists at Los Alamos National Laboratory that little data is needed for many relevant issues in a paper containing the proof which was published in Nature Communications. This provides new hope for quantum machine learning. When quantum computers outperform traditional computers, it is closing the gap between current knowledge and what's required to achieve a quantum advantage. The work eliminates the need for large datasets that would have been a barrier to quantum artificial intelligence, but other challenges still remain. Data is essential for AI systems to be able to recognize and then generalize to unseen data in real-world applications. The size of a mathematical construct known as a Hilbert space, which is exponentially larger for training over large amounts of qubits, was assumed to determine the number of parameters or variables. This made it nearly impossible to compute. Qubits, also known as quantum bits, are the fundamental computational unit for quantum computing. They are analogous to bits in classical computing. It is difficult to imagine how vast Hilbert space is, which is space of a million states, even if you have only 30 qubits. This vast space is where quantum AI training takes place. It might seem that you would need a million data points to search this vast space, but the researchers showed that you only need as many data points as the parameters in your model, which is usually roughly equal to the number of qubits. For the example of 30 qubits, you would only need about 30 data points. The results yield efficiency guarantees for classical algorithms that simulate quantum AI model simulations, and the training data and compilation can often still be done on a conventional computer, which simplifies the process. The machine-learned model then runs on a quantum computing computer. This means we can lower our requirements for quantum computer performance quality in respect to noise and error to perform meaningful quantum simulations. The speed up resulting from the new proof has dramatic practical applications. The team found they could guarantee that a quantum model can be compiled or prepared for processing on a quantum computer in far fewer computational gates. Compiling is a crucial application for the quantum computing industry and can shrink a long sequence of operational gates or turn the quantum dynamics of a system into a gate sequence. After training with a small dataset, the team showed that a quantum AI can classify quantum states across phase transitions. Creating materials with desirable characteristics, such as superconductivity, requires understanding the phase diagram. The team demonstrated this could be done by a machine learning system with minimal training. The new theorem could also be used to learn quantum error correcting codes or quantum dynamical simulations. The new method was even more efficient than the researchers had expected. They are able to compile large, complex quantum operations in just minutes using very few training points, which is something that was previously impossible. The researchers were shocked this method worked so well with only a few states required to be trained out of the billions. Deep learning framework for robotic sketching agents. A new artistic deep learning framework has been developed by researchers at Seoul National University. It is intended to improve the skills of a sketching robot. The framework was presented in a paper at ICRA 2022 and published on ArcSiv. It allows a sketching robot to learn stroke-based rendering as well as motor control simultaneously. The researchers stated that the primary motivation behind their research was to create something cool using non-rule-based mechanisms like deep learning. They also said that drawing is an interesting way to demonstrate if the performer can be a robotic arm rather than a human. Recent deep learning techniques have produced amazing results in the artistic field, but they are mostly using generative models that yield entire pixel outcomes. The researchers developed a framework to represent drawing as a sequential decision-making process instead of creating a generative model for artistic works. This sequential process is similar to how humans draw individual lines with a pencil or pen to create sketches. This team of researchers created a model that includes two virtual agent models, which are the upper and lower classes. The role of the upper class agent is to learn new drawing techniques, while the lower class agent learns how to move effectively. The two virtual agents were each trained using reinforcement learning techniques. They were then only joined after they had completed their training. The researchers then performed a series of real-world experiments using robotic arms with a 2D gripper that had 6 degrees of freedom. These initial results were encouraging as the algorithm enabled the robot agent to create good sketches of particular images. The framework could be used to improve performance of existing and new robotic sketching agents in the future. They're currently working on similar reinforcement learning-based models and a system to create artistic colleges. Make sure to like, subscribe, and enable the notification bell for the latest news in artificial intelligence, robotics, and brain-computer interface news.